Hello everyone. The questions to ask are: can a camera think? Can a camera afford not to think? Can visual storytelling influence abstract thinking? Are there any strong similarities between filmmaking and philosophy? Can both of those fields gain from interacting? Can all of that be approached on the basis of a simple introductory remarks about technology of film directing? That's what's going to happen in Thinking Camera. My name is Paweł Kuczyński and I am a mostly documentary film director. However, I also have done several narrative projects, commercials, industrials, educationals, a lot of various things. I'm a graduate of Polish Film School in Łódź. I've got from them MFA and PhD. Both of those degrees were received years after I actually finished my four-year studies. And I got a PhD kind of by accident, really, because I don't think that it's necessary for a filmmaker to have any degrees, and particularly PhDs, but I got it. I am also educated in the States. I was selected to participate in American Film Institute, CBS, reality-based programming workshop, which was actually amazing. I was also for 3 years staff producer director for something that was called IMS, Instructional Media Services, for USC School of Cinema, before it became School of Cinematic Arts. And that was sort of something in between me educating myself by the sheer fact of being around the campus, a fabulous campus, and me sort of trying to almost, I would say, teach, or maybe instruct work-study students to become part of my crew and help to produce the educationals that we've done. I started teaching in Los Angeles in various independent classes, few affiliations with smaller universities in the area, and then for over a decade I was teaching at University of Social Sciences and Humanities in Warsaw, and I taught there various kinds of classes. There is a huge book on Bergman behind me. I was for a couple of semesters teaching Bergman, analyzing Bergman films. My standard class was film directing workshop, screenwriting workshop, all sorts of stuff. And film and philosophy, actually, aside from one small strange adventure in Polish Film School that I can also talk about later, started for real in 2004 when I did Philosopher's Paradise. That movie is available to be watched. It's a documentary about my father.
This is my father, and this is my mother, both professors of philosophy at Warsaw University. The following story focuses on my attempts to understand the philosophy of my father.
The movie was well received by International Documentary Association, well enough that they chose it to be part of their traveling exhibit, theatrical exhibit of 10 movies in 2004. I was blessed actually in this film because one of the reasons why it turned out so well was that I had this very good access to the subject. It's always super important to have very good access. And my dad was very, very generous in all aspects of his time and thinking while the production was happening. And that was one of the reasons why I think people responded favorably to this film.
Hey, how are you?
All right, how are you, Janusz?
Everything is okay.
That was the beginning of trying to display philosophy on film, and I was not really satisfied with the results. It was based on sort of like a gimmick that I came up with, the idea. And the gimmick was that there is this philosopher who has a vision and I don't understand what it is. And because it's a father-son relationship, then it is sort of fueled through those family intimate dynamics. And that worked because of that, largely. But as far as the nitty-gritty connection of abstract thinking and visual thinking, as I said, I was not fully satisfied and kept coming up with different ideas, new philosophers, new concepts. And pretty much before I realized, I actually produced several of those subjects. And that gives me audacity to address the issue. Although I have to say that nothing that I will be saying here in terms of film and philosophy or filmmaking or language of film should be construed as some definite answer or a rule that needs to be followed. I don't believe that something like this exists. Definitely there are no definite answers in anything, and definitely there are no definite answers in questions how to make narrative story on screen in the best possible way. Although later on I will share with you some of my thoughts about this, but for now let's say all I can offer is the fact that I've been giving some thought to those issues, and I'm open to hearing the thoughts of the others, because we are all on equal footing. This is all uncharted territory. We are at the very beginning of the birth of new language. That 100+ years, that's really nothing of filmmaking. That's infancy, and the language is still very clumsy and very crude, and I'm sure that 10 or 15 years from now we'll be looking back at 2020 and saying, oh my god, that was so primitive what they were trying to do. It was charming, but it was really, really, really very preliminary, basic stuff. I believe that the language will evolve to become really nimble and much more precise.
Boy. Life is tragic, but we want something to tell us that this all makes sense in the last analysis. But it doesn't seem to me to make sense. Holocaust doesn't seem to make sense. You know, human suffering doesn't seem to make sense. And we are limited beings, and we want to know the truth about the world.
As the beginning of our exploration, I would like to suggest perhaps visiting one film, Andrzej Żuławski's Possession. Because this film actually introduces a very interesting problem. And the problem is, how do we handle the subject once we discover what is our subject, which is one of the biggest issues in filmmaking. Once we know what we want to talk about, how do we talk about what we want to talk about? And there are various ways to handle it, and Żuławski, in a very audacious way in Possession, showed on screen metaphorical dynamic that represents to many, many people who analyze this film the dark stuff that goes in between humans locked in marriage. And there was an issue while the movie was being developed, brought by his associates and colleagues. So those super smart people were saying, Andrzej, don't show this thing that you're gonna be showing in the movie Possession. It's about a woman who is possessed by a monster, let's put it like this for now. And he was saying, no, if we're gonna talk about something, we should go all the way, we shouldn't be beating around the bush, we show it.
What is it?
Which of course can be negated by a different approach, and that different approach will be the subject of our next meeting. See you next time.